What's up there, YouTubers? We're going to change the gear oil in my bike today. It's an 09 R1200RT, and I've done the final drive, did the engine oil. Now it's time for the gear oil. Got a couple tools here. The oil, of course. You're going to need Torx. It's a size T25. All the Tupperware has to come off. We'll get down to that point and go from there. Oh yeah. I got Baxter to help me out. Good boy. Okay, in order to get this first side panel off, there is a Torx screw that's in there. Be careful because you got your temperature sensor in there. I know you probably can't see it. There's one that comes out up here. It has the black plastic, so I put it up here. And there are two down here. Now this side should just lift off. Okay, this side lifts off. Put a little more pressure there. Should just come off no problem. Make sure everything is disconnected. Yep, there we go. Okay, so a few things about the right side Tupperware here. First of all, be careful of your temperature sensor. Okay, that's clipped on there. It needs to come off. Just make sure you get that. I'm not sure if I can do it with one hand or not. Make sure you take that off before it all, you take all the Tupperware off. You can see I have it loose here. The box, lid, there's two screws under here. When this is pushed up, you need to take those off to take this lid off, okay? The tank rack system needs to come off. There's two bolts up here. We just work your way around, take off all these Torx here. This one down here is a different size, so I took it out and then I put it back in on the other side. And now this whole thing, you can see how free it is, loose. It's just gonna come off, and I'll do that off camera because I want to take this off. I need both hands to do that, and then I don't want to scratch anything up. So I'll take that off and be right back. Okay, I've got everything loose. If it feels like it's hung up, it's because it's still connected somewhere. You need to make sure everything is disconnected, and it should come off very easily. Here's the inside of it. A little bit dirty, not bad. I'm going to put that right there. Now we have the right side exposed. Here's a good time. This is your air filter here. Back in here, this is a good time to pop this box off, the snorkel. Make sure that your air filter is clean. And get rid of any little ride-alongs there. Here is our fill for the transmission. There is the drain. You know what? I don't have to remove that. All right, disregard all that. Important thing here is make sure you can unscrew this before you drain all that. Why? If you can't get this open and you've drained all that, you're on a flatbed trucking it up to a dealership somewhere. So let's make sure that'll open and then we'll drain everything. Okay, so the fill plug takes a number 8, just regular old hex head. I've already busted it loose. So no, it's not normally that loose. I just use a little dead blow hammer to make sure. So mine is loose. I'm good to start draining. Now here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna get a piece of tin foil, cover all this up over here so I don't get oil on my exhaust and then have to smell that ugly smell until it burns off. Okay, I've wrapped up anything of importance down here. I don't like oil on my kickstand and, you know, the pipe and all that stuff. So I'm going to loosen that nut. I'm going to, in theory, catch oil in this gallon Ziploc baggie, at which point I can transfer it over. Hopefully it works. We'll see. There it goes. Nuts down in there. Yikes.
Okay, I got it. Now we're in money. Now we're... Okay.
That was close. Okay, have the plug put back in. I used a 3/4 inch socket, the six-sided version. I had a hard time believing that 3/4 inch would fit on a BMW bike, but it sure did. I guess 19 mil or something would be equivalent, but no, it fit perfectly. So now we're gonna fill this up. All this does is it gets put in here like this, and it's full when you got oil to the bottom of the threads. So we'll do that. Okay, I should probably specify I'm using Valvoline, not that the brand matters, but it's 7590 gear oil, full synthetic. Okay, since I'm here, I'm gonna check my air filter. These tabs just get pushed in top and bottom, and then the air filter snorkel gets pulled out. A little bit dirty in there. More ride-alongs. That looks pretty good. So what leads to your combustion chamber? All right, I looked at this in the light a little bit better, and it's kind of dirty. It needs to be changed. Didn't have a new one here, so I sprayed it out with the air hose. Be careful when you do that. And I'm gonna reuse it for now. So we're just gonna button it back up and call it good. Next time we're gonna do the air filter, but you've already seen how to do that. And brake pads. I need brake pads eventually, so I'll probably do a video on that. Thanks. See you later.